Hey guys, today I am super excited. I have come up with a coil, I think. At least something that I haven't seen yet. It's not any magical new wire, anything like that, just how I've put it together. I haven't seen it anywhere else online. I haven't really come up with a name for it yet. Call it Trojan Man.
Trojan Man!
Here we are. We've got here, again, nothing special. I've got 24 gauge, 10 times wrapped around a 5/64 bit. And then I've taken a flat ribbon, 28 gauge flat ribbon Canthal. And once the 24 gauge coil is complete and bent and twisted exactly how I want it, then I take and I wrap the whole thing in 28 gauge flat ribbon Canthal, Christmas wrap it. So I put this thing together, and the way I see it is you have your regular 24 gauge coil, and then because you're putting another layer, essentially a flat layer of that flat ribbon Canthal, your surface area is just grown so much that the flavor and the amount of vape is, well. Before we get started, I'll just show you the finished product here. I wicked it a little different. Everything, but what we've got here, this is just a one-sided single coil, but we've got just a single coil that we go ahead and build. Then we've got it just finished off, wrapped in the flat ribbon Canthal. So let's go ahead and build. We're taking about 12 inches 24 gauge Canthal, got 5/64 bit. We'll go ahead. We'll do 10 wraps. All right. All of this is pretty standard. Now, I'm just going to go ahead and hold my coil up to my RDA, hold it on about center, and just line it up so that I can see, okay, my left lead I want about a quarter inch over, my right lead I want about a quarter inch over. I'm just going to take and bend my guys over. So I'm just going to slide them in. So that I know, okay, it's sitting about where I want it. The next step is I'm going to take my flat ribbon Canthal. I'm just going to hold it outside so that I can start winding. You don't want a whole bunch of overlapping. You want to just get each part of the 24 gauge coil covered up. I'm going to pull her nice and tight. Now, this left lead, I've left it about twice as long. I've left the flat ribbon about twice as long as the 24 gauge, because what I want to do now, I want to take this and I want to wrap this around. I'm going to take this, and this part isn't going to be near as neat and tidy, but I want to just take and wrap this around the lead. I want to pull these nice and tight, get them nice nice and tight and hold it so that you can continue to wrap this side. Take and cut it off. Just a little bit shorter than the other flat ribbon. And there we have it. This is the Trojan Man coil. And we're just going to go ahead, just like a regular coil. Slide this guy in. Now the holes on this RDA are pretty small. Now we want to be putting, make sure, see this at one end has slipped off a little bit here. Get that guy slid back up there. There we go. We want to try and leave that as tight as possible. There we go. There we have the Trojan Man. So let's go ahead and see what we're aiming out at. So 0.4. I'm going to go ahead and wick this guy now. And then I think as a part two, I'm going to go ahead and on my other RDA, it's got a two hole positive. We can go ahead and show you guys what we are with a coil on the other side. So let's go ahead and fire this guy and show you what happens here. We've just increased our surface area so much from just that one 24 gauge coil. And that's firing just nice already. So let's go ahead and wick this bad boy. Now you can also do this. The other coil that I started out building on this was on the 22 gauge needle. So I did build the first one on that. And that works, it works very well. But I found that on the 564th, everything is just a lot easier to work with. So we will go ahead and wick this guy just a little bit different. So at first we will take this through the center. What we want to do at this point is bring everything underneath there. But now I'm just going to take this and lay it over top. Come around my positive post and tuck this underneath there again. Okay, so if it wants to do that, all I'm going to do is take and give this a little twist. Give that a little twist, and then go over my positive. All right. Let's tuck that guy in there. All right, so that's the Trojan Man coil. We've got double the surface area on a 10 wrap. Go ahead, give it a whirl. Flavor's fantastic. Trojan Man. That's fantastic. I'm going to go ahead and build that in parallel as well, with one on each side, and play with it, you know, do it in parallel wraps. But once you have your coil already built, just take that flat ribbon canthal, wrap it nice and tight, wrap it around those side leads, and, I think it's fantastic. Until next time.